attractive in my booth. So I'll probably be moving that out today, moving my things in. We'll see how much I get done today. I've got a little drive, and usually I'll feel on the way down like I am today, or I'll be listening to some of the other reselling YouTube videos and stuff. I usually will put it up just on the audio and listen to it as I'm driving. Sale. stuff out there for everybody. That's for sure. Those Polaroids are something that you can pretty easily pick up at the thrift stores. The thrift stores are getting a little savvy on those, so the traditional thrift stores, you might not get fun with that, but it's often or at your price point anyway. I don't like to pay over $5 a piece for them. I will pay for them if it's in really good shape, if it has a case with it or a manual or something like that. All of these, just the camera and strap. Tested. I don't test them. I sell them untested. I just make sure that they're as clean as possible and that the inside looks clean and all of that. And I just put that in my listing if I put it on eBay. Now you can sell to them directly. I just chose not to this time. I just went on and put them on eBay because I need some movement in my store. Charge for credit cards extra. They charge the customer, but they don't charge Christmas cards that I hand out. And the most advertising I do is when I'm having a specific sale and post it on estatesales.net. I did that. Have a company presence there. But not an ongoing ad. It was always connected with one of my sales. Or I use Craigslist, Marketplace, several of the sites. I'm on 40 plus sites that are local here. We've got a lot of them in Memphis and around the area that I live in North Mississippi. I just don't pay for advertising. I haven't paid for advertising in years, not even when I had my cleaning company. I just did word of mouth, and that's pretty much the best way to go if you can, for a lot of reasons. But I've been in business long enough that I don't have to advertise. So when I come down here, the only advertising I'm going to do is the same type. I'm just going to tweak it a little bit. I'll be running ads for sales that they're having down here, if there's vendor sales that they run, or event days, or if the farmer's market is open, you know, that's adjacent to this building, you know, let my customer base know that the farmer's market is open, hey, and come see us too, type of thing. Real good marketer. Well, I came down and I got some of my booth filled in. It's got lots and lots and lots more room in it to fill up. These are all the things that I'm bringing out of my storage. My booth goes back to the back of these tables. I'm facing the back of the other booth over here, somebody else's stuff. But as you can see, an estate liquidator has all kinds of imaginable things. Pinky and Blue Boy. My friend Calvin brought me this air mover right here. I'm going to stick it back under the table and use it again until I can get my fans out of storage and get them back up here. So that was kind of him. Thank you, Calvin. Just lots of little odds and ends. Anytime that I buy out an estate in an entirety situation, which I do some now, I used to do that all the time, I would take it to my 10 by 20 storage, and this is the stuff that's still coming out of 10 by 20 storage. Some buttons and pins. The large signs Calvin put in there for me to draw some attention to my booth while it wasn't full. Again, thank you, Calvin. Appreciate that. He's a good friend over the years and started out as a customer at my shop, so thought that was kind of interesting. He ended up down here, and I had already been thinking about coming down here and realized that he was down here, and so he's got his booths are where he can kind of keep an eye on mine when I'm not here, so that is beneficial to us both, I would imagine. And then we got all the space and poles that we can put things on and all kinds of good stuff. 16 by 16. Takes a lot to fill it up, but I've got the time.